Welcome back into the Reese's Senior Bowl film room. And today we're going to take a step back from player evaluations and take a look at the Mississippi State defense. This is a unit that's ranked number one in the country in the red zone. They've only allowed 18 scores out of 31 attempts with 10 touchdowns, 8 field goals. Let's come inside the film room and look at these Bulldogs who travel as the number one ranked team in America to Tuscaloosa on Saturday for what will be the biggest game in program history. So we're talking about red zone defense, and Mississippi State uses a four-man line, three linebackers, four defensive backs. So they're structured in a 4-3. This is against Auburn, first and goal from the 7 for the Tigers. And let's take a look and check out this Mississippi State defense. What they do is they have tremendous size up front in terms of their four down linemen. Preston Smith, Caleb Ewells are both seniors. Preston and Caleb both likely invited to the Senior Bowl. And they play with tremendous gap control up front, and then they let these linebackers fill the gaps. And you can see here where the size and the strength of this front wall really collapses Auburn at the point of attack and nowhere to run for the Tigers. Now here's the second down play. Second and 6. Auburn tries to bring some misdirection with the reverse. You can see the corner, Tevez Calhoun. Actually, that's Tolando Cleveland running across the formation. And now Marshall's going to try to go out the back door. But watch the pursuit angles of Mississippi State. These two defenders keep leverage on the outside, and here come the rest of the Bulldogs from inside out. And the key figures here, these two outside players in terms of keeping the outside arm free. And there's Matt Wells, the outside linebacker, makes a secure tackle along with Benardrick McKinney. So now first down, second down, let's go to third down for Auburn, inside the 10 for Mississippi State. And again, Auburn using regular personnel, a couple tight ends, and a player designed as a third tight end. And again, misdirection. Auburn almost conceding that we can't run against this front 7. We've got to do something different to score here. Here comes a reverse pass to CJ Uzama, who's coming around. He's looking for a receiver. Look at the discipline of Mississippi State in the red zone. Man-to-man covered, man-to-man covered. Nowhere for CJ to go with the football. And then here comes the pursuit, again, from inside out. Beniquez Brown making the ultimate stop. But watch the eyes of Benardrick McKinney. He's the guy that stirs the drink for these Bulldogs. He recognizes right away Uzama coming around on the reverse, and he's able to turn the ball back inside where his teammate Beniquez Brown is able to make the stop. So here we are again in the red zone, inside the 10, Auburn first and goal at the 6. They've got their three wide receivers on the field, their typical formation grouping. Mississippi State with their four defensive backs playing across the field. They're going to try to use these 7 defenders to control the line of scrimmage. Now, I talked in the first segment about how physical they were at the point of attack, but then they also have the quickness to make something happen in terms of beating blockers across the face. And here's A.J. Jefferson, a backup defensive end that slants inside and across the face of the Auburn tight end. He hits Cameron Artis Payne in the backfield for literally no gain, maybe a loss of 1. The interesting thing about the Mississippi State Bulldogs is they play 20 to 25 players throughout their entire defense on a regular basis. Now here's 2nd and 7. Again, the strength of this front and then the quickness in the gaps. And in this situation here, again, it's A.J. Jefferson that comes down the line and wrong shoulders the puller. Chad Slade comes around on the pull. He wrong shoulders that pull, disrupts Brandon Fulce's pull as well to go around and pick up the linebacker. And again, the pursuit of the Mississippi State front. They're airtight in terms of when you try to run the ball against them down here in a compressed area. And then we get to 3rd down. And of course, Auburn now 0 for 5 inside the 10, So now they're going to play fake and bootleg Nick Marshall to the perimeter in hopes of using his athleticism. And he has one place to go with the ball. Sammy Coates running along the back of the end zone, but Coates steps out of the back line. He's an eligible receiver. That's illegal touching. So this is going to be penalized and ruled incomplete. So there again, one of the critical factors in this matchup between Mississippi State and Alabama will be who can score in the red zone. Mississippi State, number one in the country in red zone defense. The Tide will be challenged down in the compressed area of the field. It's imperative that Blake Sims use his legs, but throw the football into the end zone.